A Switzerland village home to several hundred people called Blatten was almost completely wiped out by a large landslide. This was followed by a lake forming behind the landslide, which acted as a natural dam, flooding dozens of otherwise untouched structures up to their third floor. And then, there was a risk of a destructive outburst flood occurring, caused by the building lake breaking through and then carrying with it some of the landslide deposits, leading to evacuations downstream. Details surrounding this ongoing disaster, which ranks among the costliest landslides in Swiss history, had seemingly continued to get worse across the last 2 days. Yet today, there is thankfully finally some good news. The floodwaters no longer appear to be rising upstream of the landslide deposit, as portions of this water have begun soaking through the landslide material. This water has subsequently come out the other side, seemingly taking this pathway as shown on screen. For comparison, this is the pathway the Lonza River took beforehand. While this does mean that several now buried and destroyed structures are overlaid by a slowly forming river, it also suggests a substantially lower risk of an outburst flood occurring. As erosion continues from the flow of water through the landslide deposit, it eventually will create a modest river channel that is most likely to drain the present lake and not lead to a destructive outburst flood. While preliminary, this is why it seems that floodwaters today have seemingly stopped rising at about 11.5 meters above the normal water level, a full 2.1 meters higher than they were yesterday. Regardless, 38 structures are now flooded, up from 31 yesterday. It is still uncertain whether or not water is draining away at a higher rate than is being input into the landslide-formed lake, but for now, the input and output appear to be approximately the same. While an outburst flood is now deemed far less likely to occur, the Stasi-Verden Reservoir 3.5 kilometers downstream has been lowered from a maximum depth of 32 meters to a maximum depth of 4 meters, just in case it does end up needing to absorb an unexpected outburst flood. Also, while I had previously stated that I estimated the landslide volume to be in the range of 12.5 million to 13 million cubic meters, we now have our first official estimate of its volume, with that being approximately 10 million cubic meters. With that volume spread across an area of 2.72 square kilometers or 672 acres, this means that the average landslide thickness is 3.68 meters or 12.07 feet thick. Here is an updated map of the full landslide extent, now improved and more accurate with better geolocated data. In total, 349 structures have been destroyed by the landslide and 30 damaged, while another 38 have been damaged by the floodwaters. Note how much of the source ridge in question slid away, totaling a length of 310 meters or 1,017 feet, which now has a distinctive U-shaped scar in the mountainside. You might be thus asking, now what? Well, in addition to some uncertainties, there still are several hundred thousand cubic meters of rock that is still unstable, which could give way to additional, presumably smaller scale landslides than what struck on May 28th. This danger could, in my opinion, persist for a lengthy period of time, perhaps even weeks to months or longer, meaning that evacuated people in the deemed landslide risk area probably won't be returning for a long time. This means that flood and debris clearing efforts are also unlikely for the immediate future as well, unless the deemed risk significantly decreases. I am not sure that even if all the landslide and flood debris was cleared, the people would even be allowed to return and rebuild. As a risk factor for an area producing landslides, much like for the risk of a person having a heart attack, is a history of one or more prior incidents of such. And now, with an even steeper scarp on a segment of the northwest portion of Beechhorn Mountain, there in my opinion will be future risks. Heavy rainfall or snowfall or precipitation at all, or unusually warm days that increase meltwater volumes could further complicate the situation and lead to some murky debris and sediment-laden water flowing downstream, with such sediment and debris likely needing to be intermittently removed from the downstream Stasi-Verden Reservoir. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member Justin Arnold for supporting my work.